This video is proudly brought to you by the Wildlife Diversity Program of the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department. It's great weather for a walk outside, and in the spring and in the fall, wildlife biologists at Texas Parks and Wildlife often receive phone calls from people who are interested in the wildlife they find. Many times the only evidence that people will find of wildlife are their tracks. So, what if you found this track, a very large track, near a local riverbank? What would you think it was? Well, if you're like many people, you'd think it was made by a very large animal, maybe even a mountain lion. But it turns out that this track was made by a large-bodied dog, like perhaps a Labrador Retriever or Great Pyrenees. In the rest of this video, I'll give you a few hints to help you tell the difference between large dog tracks and mountain lion tracks. The toes in dog tracks are generally more egg-shaped, and they're arranged symmetrically around the metacarpal pad or the palm pad of the foot. And while you won't always see claws in the tracks, if you do, they're typically really robust and broad. The metacarpal pad of dogs is triangular shaped and relatively small in comparison to the rest of the track. In contrast, the toes of a mountain lion are much more round or oval shaped and are asymmetrically arranged around the pad. The third toe appears to be a little bit farther away from the pad than the rest of the toes. The palm pad of the mountain lion track has three lobes and is often described as having an M shape. Also, the pad has a trapezoidal outline instead of a triangular one and is relatively large in proportion to the rest of the track. I hope this video has helped you learn more about identifying mountain lion tracks, and if you want to continue to support wildlife conservation and management in the state of Texas, please consider purchasing a horned lizard license plate.